everybody. My name is Phil Kaye.
My name is Sarah Kaye, and we are both spoken word poets. I'm from New York City.
And I'm from California.
And we are part of an organization called Project Voice. And Project Voice brings spoken word poets like us into schools and communities around the world to share spoken word poetry, to teach workshops with students of all ages, of all backgrounds. Some of you may have noticed that Phil and I have the same last name, and we also look vaguely similar to each other.
Vaguely.
And whenever we travel around together, usually the first question that we get asked is whether we're brother and sister, but the answer is no. And then, because of our last names, sometimes people want to know if we're married, and the answer is also no. Thank you to the one person who laughed at that. And then sometimes people want to know if we're dating, if we have dated, if we will date, if we're secretly dating, all of which is a no.
And definitely not.
And the true story is that I grew up here in New York City, and Phil grew up in California on the opposite side of the country. And so neither one of us knew that the other person existed for most of our lives. And then completely by coincidence, we ended up going to the same college. And in the very first week of our freshman year at college, during freshman orientation, they had a talent show. And anyone in the freshman class could be in that talent show. And we both happened to sign up. We both happened to do spoken word poetry. And that is where we met. And we realized pretty quickly that we had the same last name. And we said, oh, that's a funny, weird coincidence. And then all of these other funny, weird coincidences started to appear around us. And at this point in our friendship, we've pretty much gotten used to every single funny, weird coincidence the world could possibly throw at us. But whenever we perform together, whenever we meet a new group of people, we always like to share this story because we think it's a pretty good one. And also, we hope that it will give you some kind of explanation for what's going on here.
This is all 100% true.
It started with a sweater.
I was looking fly. First day of college orientation as a freshman, and I'm the type of guy who's always trying to make a good impression.
He looked like a tool. And it's the first week of school, so I've got people to meet and things to try. I don't have time to waste on this guy hanging out backstage at a talent show.
It started with a freshman talent show. A chance to showcase what I know about spoken word and poetry, try to get some people to notice me.
It started with a technical difficulty.
Some sort of delay.
Somebody's iPod track wouldn't play.
So I'm stuck waiting backstage when I notice this girl.
And he walks over, stupid sweater and all. There was nowhere to run. Backstage was too small.
And I'm so nervous about going on stage that I decide to strike up a conversation.
Sorry, I completely got ahead of myself. I totally skipped introductions. My name is Sarah Kaye.
My name is Phil Kaye. I'm from California.
Born and raised in NYC.
Let's see, a fun fact about me.
My mom is Japanese and my dad is Jewish. Not a common combination, but I think it's kind of cute. People call me Japa Jew.
Japanese.
Ashkenazi Kamikaze.
And come December,
Hanukkah and Christmas. Plus, you should taste my mother's brisket. Jan Kawamura's matzo ball soup with noodles brings my father Jeffrey to his knees.
It took Mom Reiko and Dad Michael to raise this lanky half-breed.
Well, I think that's it. My mom, my dad, and me. Oh, plus my little brother. He's 22.
My little sister is a deadpan firecracker. She's 22 and she keeps me on track. Her name is Sarah.
My brother's name is Philip.
Anyway,
where was I?
It started with a backstage interaction.
No, it started with a backwards first impression.
Okay, well, I'll tell you where it did not start. It did not start at our fifth grade summer camp.
That's true. It did not start at our summer camp junior lifeguards, even though
we were both there. In our matching uniforms, red bathing suit, white t-shirt, visor, and
our counselor, Mr. Johnson, who probably figured that the shy girl in his morning class
and the skinny kid in his afternoon class were cousins.
He probably thought that we had carpooled over together
in between family photo shoots and 4th of July barbecues.
But instead, we merely coexisted.
Almost met, but always missed it.
Spinning round like two sides of a coin. Look, we've done the research, and we swear we're not related.
And we've never dated.
And we're never, ever going to.
Because what are the chances of finding someone with your last name?
Japanese and Jewish with siblings called the same.
What are the odds of finding someone
who can finish your sentences?
Who will let you cut in line?
Who knows not to just lend a hand or an ear when you need them to give you their spine?
Who is woman enough to be best man at your wedding?
Who will keep every secret, save every letter, tell you how you really look.
Who will remember every single one of your birthdays.
Without checking Facebook.
What are the odds of finding someone who knows your poetry by heart?
Who won't freak out if you're hanging out and you accidentally fart.
Yeah, and if you have a date and you need to look fresh, I will let you borrow my hair products.
And if you do not have a date and you need to look fresh, mm-hmm. I will let you borrow my cousin.
I will always see you for the alley-oop.
I will always save you a seat.
I will always pick you to be my partner, even though you are terrible at handling.
When the fire takes all you have, my home will be your home.
When you are old and can no longer remember my face, I'll meet you for the first time again and again.
When they make fun of your accent, I will take you swimming, because we all sound the same underwater.
When Ellis Island tries to erase your past, I will call you by your real name.
When they call your number for the draft, I will enlist to fight beside you.
And I will march with you from Selma to Montgomery and back as many times as it takes.
We will stand together against the hoses and the dogs,
because it didn't start with us. It started with Lennon and McCartney.
It started with Thelma and Louise.
It started with Winnie the Pooh and Christopher Robin.
Bert and Ernie.
Abbott and Costello.
Rosencrantz and Guildenstern.
Mario and Luigi.
Watson and Sherlock.
Pikachu and Charizard. And they could tell you what a miracle this is.
They could tell you how rare this is.
But they could tell you how rare friendship always is.
The chances are slim.
The cards are always stacked against you. The odds are always low.
But I have seen the best of you
and the worst of you.
And I choose both.
I want to share every single one of your sunshines and save some for later.
I will tuck them into my pocket so I can give them back to you when the rains fall hard.
Friend, I want to be the mirror that reminds you to love yourself.
I want to be the air in your lungs that reminds you to breathe easy.
When the walls come down.
When the thunder rumbles.
When nobody else is home. Hold my hand, and I promise
I won't let go.